Somebody said they'd like to see the inside of this motor, and I would too. I thought I was the only weirdo that liked taking stuff apart just to see how it's built, but apparently not. So this is the motor that came out of the microwave, the little turntable motor, and it ain't working, so let's dig in. Let's see what's in there. Oh, I see. I see. Okay, you see this gear here. Right here, this gear right here is missing all those teeth. Let me see if I can get this thing to turn around. That's the problem. Okay. Right here, this gear. It's missing all these teeth right here. Pretty interesting. Well, that's a man, talk about a whole bunch of little step down gears. Very, very interesting. So that's it. Are you happy? Is your curiosity satisfied? Mine is. Since I got it open, let's just take it apart, huh? There we go. Yeah. See the missing teeth? Let me get a rag. Let's see if we can take this inner cover off and see what the motor itself looks like. Those were just the gears there. Okay, now, I'm not sure how these work. This must be one big armature on the outside here, and this must be magnetic. Yep, it is. Yeah, it's magnetic. Okay, I get it. It's just a very flat motor. You know, if you would look at it this way, a normal motor would be, you know, from here to here. It would be a really long armature with a magnet in the middle. But, yeah, I understand. It's the same premise as a regular motor, regular armature. There you go, there's the windings. Very interesting. Okay, now I'm happy. I guess if you were a scrapper, you'd take that copper out of there. Well, hell, I'm not doing nothing. Let's see how much copper is in there. I'm gonna back you out just a little bit. It's hard to keep my hands right underneath that. You know what? I'm gonna be here all day. That is tiny, tiny little strand of copper, wound a whole bunch of times. I don't know if you can see the copper. Can you see that? Tiny little, it's like, I mean, it's like maybe the thickness of a hair. Okay. And there's a whole bunch of it in there. Can you see that? Alrighty. To the people that gave me links to the motors, I guess a good thing to tell you. I did buy one from eBay for $10, this exact motor. I'm really, really pleased somebody else did my work for me. Thank you very much for sending me a link right to the motor on eBay and all the other people that sent me links. I really appreciate it. And that is one of the things I love about YouTube, is so many people coming together to help each other. Well, thanks again. This has been an interesting little disassembly. And when I get the motor in the mail, they're saying I should have it by March 31st, from March 31st to April 11th. In that time frame, whenever I get it, and just take me a second to pop it in, I'll show you. Thanks for watching.